around to doing my actual packing video of the Fawn Design Mini in the new fall 2018 color, which, well, they have three colors, a navy, a wine, and this one, which is called Honey. It's more of an orangey, yellowy color than the brown or any other shade of brown they've come out with. It's closer to the color of a pumpkin, I would say, than a brown. So on my Instagram, which is Bun Bun's Mom, the same exact handle as my YouTube, I have several pictures of this bag wearing it, and also just next to various shades of brown, various shades of orange, and yellow hues, so that you can get a better feel for what color this bag is in all different lightings and stuff. It's an awesome fall color. I've had a million girls ask me where I got this bag, how much they love it. It pairs well with any outfit I've worn this fall. I've been rocking this bag every day since I got it, and I got it a few weeks ago. I've been using it, packing it to the brim, and I'm a total overpacker. So just so you guys know, the minis have stayed the same. They did make new additions to their original, like a grab handle and the slip pocket in the back that you can remove the straps and tuck them in. This bag doesn't have that. These backpack straps are attached on forever. There is a shoulder strap that comes with the bag where you can attach, which you can attach to these two D-rings, and wear it as a shoulder bag. Or over the shoulder bag or crossbody bag or whatever they call it. So anyway, let's just get right into it. So in this front zippered pocket, all I have in here right now is the pill case that I bought from an Etsy shop. That's all I have in here, as you can see. So you can see it through the bag. You could also fit like two lip glosses in this pocket right next to it. I've also shoved my keys in here, but on my car keys, I literally only have my house key and my car key, so, and a carabiner, but it did fit in there next to this pill case. So it's a tight pocket, but you can fit small items in here, like up to three small items, I would say. So this is the pill case that I have. It's really small, so to compare it to my hand, it's tiny. So it takes up like less than half of this front side, this front zipper pocket, which does go all the way down to the bottom of the bag. If you put anything in this front slip pocket, which I do have two items in here, then it does take away from how many things you can fit in this zippered pocket, but it's still functional. In this, I'll put in the notes section the Etsy shop that made this pill case. They have tons of different designs. They're really cute. They're small, and they just fit the perfect amount of pills that I would need. I'm not big on pills, but in case other people need them is why I usually have this. I just have Excedrins, I have Benadryls, and some other allergy pill that my husband has or takes sometimes. I don't even know where it is. Special thing. I think that's what that is. Anyways, so that goes back in there really easily. And the material that this bag is, everything slips in and out of it so well. The material is really smooth and not tacky at all, so nothing grabs. In the front slip pocket, that also goes all the way down to the bottom front of the bag. What I have in here is a Y pouch mini. I just take the zippered portion and fold it over to make it be able to fit. It is too wide if you don't, I guess I could kind of fit it in, but it would just get kind of messed up. So if you fold the zipper part over, it fits in and out of this pocket readily. I've been folding this over for the past several weeks to put it into this bag, and it has not compromised the functionality of this bag, the Y pouch. The Y pouches are just amazing quality. They don't fall apart no matter what you do. It'll go right back flat if I like lay this down with a book over it like for a few hours. But what I put in here are the boogie wipes, the saline boogie wipes. I constantly am grabbing this out of my bag. I have to refill it like every night. It's pretty depleted at this point. I I use these to constantly wipe my kids' faces, hands, just everything, just all day long, especially right now because it's the, you know, flu, beginning of the flu and sicky season. The last thing I have in this pocket is a notepad. And I just got this as a gift from my grandma, so that worked out perfectly because it's tiny. And I'm old school and like to write my notes down, my handwritten notes. If I put them in my notes section of my phone, I'll forget about it and never see it again until the next time I look in my notes section. So I have to have things handwritten in order to remember them. And so yeah, those two items fit perfectly in there. I'm sure you can fit other things there, especially, but yeah, the Y pouch, if you just want to put that, that's a good idea as well. I know you can also, I can also fit my phone. I'm using my phone for the video, otherwise I'd show you. I have an iPhone 7S Plus or something like that. It's huge, but it does fit into the pocket all the way down and doesn't show above this slip pocket. But then again, if I was out at like a festival or something, I wouldn't really want my phone there because it would be easily grabbed out. So I usually just put my phone either in my back pocket of my pants or just right on top on the inside of the bag. Because my phone is too wide high to fit inside these side pockets, and the bag has the same exact size side slip pockets on either side. And what I have on this side, oh, and the pockets go all the way down to the bottom. I have a Sunbum hand sanitizer that I just grabbed at Target. It's small. And next to that, I have this guy, which fits perfectly in there. Those two items right next to each other. This is just a hand cream from Bath & Body Works. And so I use that for myself constantly throughout the day. Hand sanitizer and along with the boogie wipes, like just spray my kid down and wipe them. I'm doing that all day long. So it's good to have those things easily accessible. In this side, and again, they go all the way down. So I have like a lot of long things in here, like my pen and my notepad. A Sharpie, because with my toddler, I feel like I always need the Sharpie. Like when we get somewhere and he needs like a name tag or I need to write his name on something. I needed it for something the other day. I can't think of what it was, but it was like a common thing that I always need a Sharpie for, and now I can't think of it. I have this perfume roller. This is Gucci Guilty, which smells really good. And I got this from Sephora, and they have tons of different roller size perfumes at Sephora. And it's just like kind of the size of a thick pen, and it fits perfectly in here. And then also, lastly in this pocket, I have my son's chapstick that I got off of Etsy. It's like a chocolate flavor one, and it's all organic, and there's no like petroleum or weird chemicals or toxic things or habit making things in here. But he actually has the habit of picking his lip when he's like an anxious situations, like arriving somewhere, he'll like pick the skin off of his lip. So I've been giving him that, his own chapstick. I just hand it to him, and he can just like sit there and put chapstick on his lip instead of picking his lip. It's been working out really well. The cool thing about that chapstick, let me take it out again, is that it does have a little carabiner attached to it. So I have also, like when my bag is really full, I've clipped this onto here. Or you can also clip your keys onto here if you have a carabiner. That's what I do with my keys, but yeah, anything with a carabiner I'm all about, because I love that these bags have such sturdy, strong, durable D-rings all around them. So I'm all about clipping things on. However, it kind of compromises the look of the bag, having things like hanging about on it. But anyway, oh, and also another thing I love about this bag is that even when it's empty, it just sits structured like this. It doesn't fall over, it just stays sitting up like this. So, I mean, it's heavy and full of a bunch of stuff right now, but even if it was empty, which I'll show you in a moment, it'll stay standing up, and I just love that. I've had so many bags where I'm like rummaging through, like when my son was younger, and I'm like pulling something out and the whole thing jumps over, and it's like already a stressful situation because you're like trying to find something for your needy little toddler in the moment. So bags that don't fall over, that are structured and made well, are just it's worth it. Like, I think this bag was like $89 or something, and it's just like, just for the fact that it doesn't topple over is worth the $89 for me. But anyways, so this is the last compartment. It's the main compartment. It has one zipper that goes all the way around this kind of half circle shape of the bag. It's a really nice zipper. All of the Fawn Design products have this really nice, like, thick, durable, smooth zipper that'll like never fail, and I like that. I'm never get caught up in anything in my bag, and I'm an overpacker, so I always pack this thing to the brim, and I've never had an issue. So anyways, yeah, to open it up, you just pull this back. I usually fold this over, and then my bag will like just stay completely open. So what I always have sitting on the top of my, just on the top of everything in the bag, is this, which is a custom jujube print pouch that I got off of Etsy from Love Me 04, is her Etsy shop handle. I don't know if you can see that. That's her little tag in her bag. These bags, these custom jujube bags, are the perfect size to fit, just to compartmentalize everything in your bag, and they work really well with these Fawn Design mini bags, because all of these little mini jujube custom pouches that they sell on Etsy come in all different sizes. This is like the biggest size you can get, and the little ones fit perfectly, as I'm about to show you, in the slots that are inside of this main compartment. But anyway, in here I just have like some of the Trader Joe's suckers that you can grab from their treasure chest, gummies, some bars. I usually have Z bars in here, fruit leathers, raisins, you know, just snacks to keep my kid happy when we're out and about, obviously. I'm all about these, just these little mini board books that you can get at Target or wherever. And this, you know, these two items are kind of like the exact same size, so I just keep these on top, on the very top of my bag, just because they kind of, I feel like I need them at the same time. Like, my kid always wants a snack when we're waiting somewhere to keep him occupied, so I can give him a snack, keep his, you know, mouth and mind occupied with a snack and a book. I don't know if that makes sense. Okay, anyway, right here I have my son's sunnies. I usually throw my own sunnies in here as well, like, you know, either like on this side of the bag or whatever. Just kind of laying on top so that they don't get damaged or squished. So those are mine, or my son's. Mine are in the car right now. Also kind of just lying on top. Sorry, my bag's kind of disheveled right now. Whoops. So we're out right now, and I've been digging through it while we've been here. But anyway, that's what it looks like from the top view. It looks kind of crazy. Again, for my son's kind of picking habit, I went back into my baby storage bins and had to take out this guy so that he can like chew on this and occupy his like need for picking or whatever he's doing, his little anxious tic that he's developing. This is cool. This is one of those extra gum containers, and I took the extra, you know, cardboard out of the inside of it once I chewed all the gum, and I started putting the crayons that we collect from restaurants inside here so they don't get cracked. And then also stickers that we get from places like the doctor's office or Disneyland is constantly, they're giving the kids stickers. So I just put all the stickers in here, and I feel like those are always necessary when we're at a restaurant, stickers and crayons. My son always wants those. And just also some couple of coloring sheets that I have are just like folded up behind in the very back of all my stuff. So I'll just bust these out. These we just got at the pumpkin patch. I got a couple of them. So I just fold these up, and you know, I have crayons and stickers for whenever we might need those. Are you gonna eat some more snacks, buddy? You're getting tired, I can tell. Okay, so right, let's see, which one should I start with? Okay, right here, I just have everything kind of sitting,
mommy,
like where, yes, there he is, go get him. I can see all of my bags that I have, and just pull each one out from the top of it. So I have each bag in there vertically next to one another. So in here, this is the an Itsy Ritzy small snack bag. It comes in a set of two matching. I'm not using the other one right now. But inside here, I have all of, my son and I both have really long hair, and I have all of our hair needs, a couple of clips and my hair tie, all my son's hair pretties, and another one of these Jujube custom pouches that I got on Etsy. It's a small little one, and I love just these clear windows that you can see what's inside of the bag. And that's all fitting in here. And then also a mini wet brush. And usually I have a Sephora, like mini, like skinny, what's it called? Spray bottle. And then I have leave-in conditioner in there. And then that also fits in this bag, but I obviously didn't put it back in the last time I used it.
I have to go poo-poo.
Okay, do you know where the potty is? It's right there. Okay, go. Good job telling me. Go. Okay, go with him to go potty, please. I'm almost done, Kate. And also, I have next to that, I have a Jujube small set piece. This is in space place print. And inside of here, what I have is a mini deodorant that I got at a stand in California Adventure in Disneyland. Mini deodorant. And then I also have these like small organic tampons that you can get at Target, and they're small, they're compact, so I can fit like a million of them in this bag. And so that all fits together in there. There's like 10 tampons in there in case me or like a million other people might need one. Okay, bud, go over there. I'm gonna help you in a moment. I'm almost done. And then right here I have, this is another Jujube custom pouch that I got on Etsy. So this is more restaurant needs. I have, or just eating needs in general. I have two stainless steel straws for my son. Also a silicone straw, which also pairs as a teether. Spoon, a fork. Oh, also what I have in here, which I really, really love and you find myself using all the time, are these sticky placemats that can adhere to pretty much any surface. I have that folded up just in case we're somewhere that's yucky, but I still need to give my kids some snacks. You can use this in lieu of a plate even and just spread everything out. But fold that up and it fits right in there. Okay, he's gonna have to wait, okay? I'm almost done. And also what I have folded in there is a Jujube beanie knit bib. Okay, and these are awesome. I love that I love the magnetic strap or buckle thingy, and the this thing that catches everything that they drop. And then lastly, behind that, I have this little Bumpkins small Disney snack bag. And what I do is I put the dirty utensils, straws, dirty beanie bib in here, and then when we get home I take this out and wash everything in there, plus this, and just directly in the sink, and it's all good. In the very back I have a wipe pouch 30 that just slides in and out. Super cute, pairs really well with the other monochrome print, and it just looks nice with any color bag, really, the black and white prints. I just got also in the main compartment, I have this new wallet. I will put that on the notes section of the video, but it's super duper thin. You can put cash and receipts in here. I just kind of ditched my big bulky wallet because I'm like, why do I need a huge bulky wallet when I can just have this super like paper thin wallet that holds the cards I need? I'm not a credit card user. I don't use credit cards. I mean, I have like one, but I don't use it, but it's nice to have in a pinch. My ID, my Target card, my son's, and my medical insurance card, just my main card, my main cards that I do find myself using, I keep in here, and then I can also put cash in there. I'm big on using cash. What else do I have in this main middle compartment? I have this bag, which is a medium Bumpkin snack bag, and this black and white heart monochrome print, which also looks really good with the white pouch mini, the white pouch 30. I'm really into the black and white prints right now. Inside here, I have just random toys for my son. I have this guy, a fidget spinner, and I like that, you know, I don't fold it to the brim, and then that way I can fold it over and put it, tuck it into the bag. But yeah, just a bunch of little things that can keep his little hands occupied in a restaurant. The like Disneyland blind bag toys. You know, usually I'll have the blind bag in here and then I'll let him open the blind bag in the store. But then every time we open the blind bags, I just let it, like, put the toys back into this bag. So yeah, a lot of figures and stuff. Little things for restaurants. I have all of my loose change, and a lot of times I'll put cash in this. It's a Great Wolf Lodge coin bag. Right here I have this, which I got from Container Store, and this has all my charging needs in it. It has like three compartments in it, so I put all my cords in one side. I put the cord that I need to attach to the charging block right there in the middle, and I put my, you know, Jackery mobile phone charger in there, and a charging block, and everything I need to charge, all my charging needs in there. That like always comes in handy at all day things like Disneyland. So then now you can kind of see there's a big pocket in the back, a big slip pocket in the back, and then there's four tiny ones that are equal size that go along the front and the two sides. So on this one, this one, I have just your regular Kleenex tissues. And this one, I have another Jujubee custom pouch from Etsy with like all my son's skin needs. He has eczema, and so I need a lot of the eczema creams. I use the ones that the doctors give me, the like sample sizes. I put those in here, and there's also Neosporin in there. There's Band-Aids in the very back. There's a small sunscreen stick in there. I love those clear windows so I can see what I want is and grab it out. Another exactly the same size Jujubee custom piece from Etsy with all of my like metal tools that I need. Like I have down there, I have a mini screwdriver for like toys that need to be opened immediately. Because they're all screwed in nowadays into their packaging. Tweezers, mini scissors, my son's nail clippers, my nail clippers. Okay. On this side, all these pieces fit so perfectly. These Jujubee custom pieces fit so perfectly in these on these little slip pockets in the Jujubee or the Bond Design mini bag. Okay, so in here I have like a concealer, a primer, lotion, little like mini makeup spongy things, and Q-tips, okay, just to like if I need to fix my face or something while we're out and about. And so yeah, that fits just super easily into these little pockets, all these little mini custom Jujubee pieces from Etsy, which I will link those in the notes. And this big one, in this big slip pocket back here, which is also a good place to put your iPhone or your big phone, whatever, all the phones are so big now. But this fits really well. It's the next size up on the Jujubee custom pouches on Etsy. And in here I just have more quick grab makeup needs that I feel I need all the time. Chapsticks, MAC gloss, MAC lipstick. There's a mini custom Jujubee mirror in the back, and an eyelash curler. These custom Jujubee mirrors are also sold by usually these girls who make the bags. It's pretty cool to just have that in there ready to go for if I'm doing my makeup in my car really quick or while I'm waiting in line somewhere. And lastly, what I have at the very bottom of the bag, just kind of crushed down, smushed down there underneath everything that's standing on top of that vertically to grab out quickly, I have this, which is a Jujubee, comes with the Be Equipped set. Okay, it's mesh, it's clear so you can see what's inside. And it also has the gold hardware, so it pairs really well with the fawn design. And inside of here, what I have are a pair of underwear for my son, a pair of socks for my son. He's wears size 5T, even though he's 3. Pair of shorts. The wet bag that comes with the Jujubee Be Equipped set, folded up at the very bottom. Okay, so in case he does soil his clothes, I can put the dirty ones in there and put it back in here. And then lastly, this, it's like called Spray That Bottom. It's just like a essential oils, organic spray where I can just spray him, his legs down, everything, if he like, pees on himself, or just spray him down, if he, whatever kind of accident it is. I can just spray him down, wipe him down with some wipes, and he's ready to go. And this just folds down really small, so it's great to put at the bottom of this bag so that everything else can sit atop and can be easily grabbed out. So anyways, and here the bag is, totally empty, and it just stands right up. Doesn't fall over. Super structured, amazing bag. And that's that, and I hope you guys liked this packing video, and I hope it was helpful, and I hope you buy this bag because I've loved it. I haven't stopped wearing it since I bought it and packed it up. Happy shopping!